As I said yesterday, today we are going to start from the very beginning. Since when this Sahaja Yoga started? When I talk to you, I have to again request that as a scientist, you must keep your mind absolutely open. And do not hang on to any point which comes up in your mind. But try to understand that whatever I am telling you is today maybe a hypothesis for you, but tomorrow it will become a complete scientific proof. For you have to understand the science of God's love. Perhaps people cannot understand that all the sciences have come from God Almighty Himself. To understand God's love and divinity, one has to open oneself to that absolute position from where all relativity disappears. We are living in the atmosphere of relativity. We have to find out our absolute. Unless and until we find out our absolute, we are always in confusion and we think that this may be all right or that may be all right. If this is all right, that could be all right. We try to decide everything through our rationality. As the Lord has already told you, rationality is a limited means. And I am talking of the unlimited. So if you have to go to unlimited, it has to be beyond the rationality. So with the open mind, I hope you listen to me. After realization, when the power starts flowing through you, then you will be able to know how to maneuver it, how to understand it, and how to keep it moving. Like one would explain about electricity first, then give you an experiment with the electricity flowing, and explain to you how to use it. By using the electricity, you will be convinced that it is a scientific proof. I could have started the lecture from creation, but that would be too much to begin with. I would start it from your own being. When you are a human being, you are not aware as to what are you inside. As far as your physical body is concerned, doctors only see the outside of your being. The inner subtle forces which are creating you, which are looking after you, and which are making you exist, you are absolutely unaware of. In our being, there is, first of all, is the power which enters into our being from right-hand side and goes to the left-hand side, which we call as Mahakali Shakti, is the power of Mahakali. This Mahakali Shakti manifests within us a power which runs through the Ida Nadi. Now this Nadi or this subtle channel is inside the brain and inside the spinal cord. This being the energy, you cannot see it when it is dissected. For example, if you dissect this, you won't find the electricity flow. This Ida Nadi on the left hand side, gives us our existence and at the height in the gross manifests our left sympathetic nervous system. We exist because of this Idaranya. This is also manifesting all our emotional side of life, which comes from our past. So it has all the past that is within us. So Idaranya manifests, or we can say accumulates, all that is our past, atheet. This is our existence. We take it for granted that exists. We do whatever we please in our ahankara, in our own understanding. We try to our level best to destroy ourselves, and we reach a point where we have to give up. This is all decided for you, how long you have to exist. It is all predestined. If you have to die at a point, you will die. There is no one who is going to stop that. So some people who come and tell me, Mother, somebody is dying or dead, can you make him live? If he has to live, he'll definitely live. Only the miracle of God makes you believe in him. But your time and birth and death are absolutely destined, which must be accepted. It is not the way it is described in your kundalis or in your horoscopes. In the horoscope, for example, a gentleman was to die about 5-6 years back. And he came to me, he got his realization, and he lived much longer after that. He's still living. So he went to his Pandit and he asked him, how is it you had predicted that I'm going to die this year and still I'm living? Then he saw into the horoscope and he said, by the way, did you meet any great spiritual personality? He said, I did meet someone. He said, that's the reason. I should have told you that if you had met, if you meet this lady, then this will be avoided. And it was to be avoided, and he met me. So in a way, there is a sanjoga always. Because you are here, you should not think that you have deliberately come here. But it was to be that you should be here. Now, if you do not take the advantage of this sanyoga, that freedom is with you. But sanyogas are created by God. He organizes and arranges that you meet the right person, that you get the right thing. But it is left to your freedom to choose the right or the wrong. Mostly, we go according to our own whims and understanding. Even then, if supposing our understanding was a pure understanding and a simple understanding, we would know, we would be very sensitive to know who is the real person and who is not. But normally, when we live, we play with our existence. We try to minimize our sensitivity. This left side can be described also as a destructive side, because if it does not exist, it is destructive, it destroys you. That's why it is called also a destroying power. That by this power you can be destroyed if you are not to be existing anymore. The same power can destroy you. Now this left side power is very important and is very, very vital for our country, especially where we have traditions within us. Left-sided people, those who are indulging into left side too much, are very emotional and they take to bhakti. If they take to bhakti, they'll go on calling God and working on that and doing all kinds of emotional expressions to get to. This bhakti cult developed into our country, God knows how many years back, but has been working. And there have been many people who have been getting into this bhakti cult. But when you cross a certain limit of this left side, you enter into collective subconscious area. If this is the subconscious, then you go beyond that. If you go into collective subconscious, then you might find yourself attacked by people whom you do not know or maybe you know. And that's how we get people to get possessed. All your emotional problems, all your mental problems, which are called as lunacy and all that are coming because of the defective behavior in this area. If you go into the left side area, as I told you, by any means, like supposing some people are very fond of going to the cemeteries. I don't know why, but there are some funny people like that. We had a doctor in London. He is a Russian doctor, but now he's in Australia. He came to me and he had a problem on this left hand side, Idanadi. And I was amazed. I said, how can this doctor from Russia and living in Australia and now in London can have such a problem like that? I asked him several questions. Do you live near a cemetery, or do you have somebody dead in your family? Have you wept for someone? Somebody has shocked you? Or what has happened that this left side is so weak in you? Or have you indulged into too much of drug taking or something like that? He said, "None, mother, I have not done anything like that. Neither have I been this way." Then I said, "You try to remember." Then he remembered that his grandmother was very fond of going to the cemetery. And in his childhood, she used to take him in the pram. Then when he was walking also, she used to take him. Until he was quite old, she always used to take him to that cemetery. Just imagine. It's such a funny thing that we do not know in our past how we have indulged into this left-hand side acting. Now, in our country, whatever traditions we have had, all of them mostly come from the great saints who have meditated. Not most of them, but I would say quite a lot of them. But we cannot say there is not a single tradition which is wrong in India. But the traditions can get perverted later on. But basically, if you see, our traditions are very sensible. Like when a person dies, whatever rituals we have is a very, very sensible ritual. We Indians are not aware of it, the rituals that we do. Of course, in that, when the Brahmins start taking money, that's the perversion. Nobody should take money if somebody is gone. It's very simple to do that because he'll be affected by the left-hand side attacks. Those people who do all this kind of work and earn money out of the death of others are very dangerous in place. Moreover, when you also find that somebody is dead in your family. So many people, when they come to me, I find left-hand side is a problem in India. The reason is this: somebody is dead. Say the father has died early or a mother has died early. Then people start worrying about that person. If father has died at a very early age, supposing in the case of a girl who feels very insecure, all the time she is thinking about him, then that kind of a mind can create a problem on the left hand side. And we have to clear it out. That's why very important what we do in India. Somebody dies, we start playing the band and all that, so that our ideas get out of it. Those people have died, have gone to another world. They have to go. They are not to hang around here. And we are not to keep them back and keep them under our bondage of our emotions. This we should understand. You see, in modern times, we just give up everything that was old is a very wrong thing. Because whatever they have discovered is of eternal. I've seen people, even if you tell them that you forget about it, now don't worry about it, they won't listen, and then you find them getting into serious diseases like epilepsy, into lunacy and other mental troubles. Especially among women, we find hysteria develops if this kind of a problem is there. Now, it is not easy to believe into a thing that there is something like dead bodies hanging around. It's very, very difficult for any educated man to believe into such a nonsense, but they do. You have to know that they do exist. Now, that doesn't mean that you believe in their powers, but that you must know that they exist, and that's why you have to keep in your maryadas. You have to keep in the center and don't go too much on one side. In bhakti also, when people overdo it, like if they start weeping and crying and saying that, oh Lord, you must come and give us some darshan or something like that. Till evening they fast and they say that unless and until you appear before us, we are going to die. All these things, when you try, these emotional style of working it out, you cannot achieve, because this is your manasa, this is your mind. Through your mind, you cannot achieve God. By crying and weeping, you're going to tantrums. You'll do all kinds of nonsensical things that people may think you are a madcap. They might think you are just acting, or they, I don't know what they will think. But you do not achieve anything by this kind of cry. For example, now we have in India, it started here, I think, this Hare Rama, Hare Krishna cult. So these people are so funny that in Oxford Street, if you go in London, you'll find them wearing those dhotis and saris. They don't know how to wear and how to carry on with them. And taking a dholki in the hand, and with great gusto, they are going on, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. And the sari falls off, and the dhoti falls off, and they also wear those bodhis, you see, which are attached to the thing with a little glove, I think, or gum or something, because they don't have, so they have to buy it in the market. They have made a market out of it. They are selling all these things in the market. They are selling the dhotis, they are selling these, they don't know how to wear dhotis, then there's somebody who will make you wear, they shave off their hair, they do all these things. बैठ जाइए उठिए ने बीच में लोगों का अटेंशन बहुत सेंसिटिव होता है कोई खड़ा हो गया तो आप जरूर से देखिए
इतना क्रिटिकल होना ठीक नहीं
है अच्छा आप बाहर जाइए क्योंकि आपके समझ में आने नहीं वाला हम क्यों क्रिटिकल है आप बाहर जाइए हमें जो कहना हमें कहने दीजिए देखिए हमें जो कहना हमें कहने दीजिए आपसे क्या
क्रिटिकल
जहाँ क्रिटिकल है वहाँ क्रिटिकल होना है वो तो आपको पता नहीं कि क्राइस्ट ने तो हंटर लेके मारा था इन लोगों हम तो कम से कम शब्दों से ही बोल रहे हैं जो बात झूठ है वो झूठ है और जो सच है वो सच है और वो कहने में हमारी हिम्मत है उसकी आप दाद दें आपको आपको अभी उसका अंदाजा हुआ नहीं है ना आगे की सुन लीजिए एक मिनट अच्छा उससे व्हाट हैज हैपेंड विद दैट व्हाई आई एम क्रिटिसाइजिंग और विद ऑल दिस व्हेन दे कम टू मी दे हैव कैंसर ऑफ द थ्रोट नाउ विल यू क्योर दैट विल यू क्योर दैट इट इज वेरी इजी फॉर यू टू शाउट हियर दिस नॉट अ पॉलिटिकल मीटिंग दैट यू कम एंड टॉक नो बट यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम टॉकिंग They are suffering from cancer of the throat. देखिए आपको अच्छा नहीं लगता है तो आप बाहर चले जाएं जो मुझे कहना मैं गाऊंगी आपको सुना
It is better if she is critical. By critical mind, being minded, you can
After all, I'm not going to say that you go and do the same thing. You know, these boys, when they come to me, they are suffering from cancer of the throat. Now, is this gentleman going to cure? I have cured them. And I have to go through it. What has he done so far that he's talking? He should keep quiet because he doesn't know anything, he has no authority just now. And please understand that this is not the way to listen to me. I'll say what I have to say. I'm not afraid of anyone. And if anything is wrong, I'm going to say it even if you crucify me.
Very good.
Now this is what I was going to, that if you do such a thing, extraordinary thing, you develop cancer. Yesterday only I had said, how do you get into sympathetic attitude? I'm just telling you, this is how you get into left-hand sympathetic attitude. And do you know, cancer is caused by left-hand problem, not by the right hand, which is physical. Just have some patience about it. This kind of nonsense if you start doing in the house, And if you get tomorrow the cancer, now I'll tell you exactly the name of the person and everything. I'm not afraid of anything. Because I have cured it. I've got the proof of it and I can show you that. There was Dr. Mulay. You can contact him. I don't know if he's come today. He sent one boy to me. Only 12-year-old boy, suffering from leukemia. 12-year-old boy. And he came to me, he was suffering from leukemia. And when I went into his history and all that, I couldn't find any trace of his father going into any guru or any wrong type of person. But when I asked him about his grandfather with whom this little boy was living, he had a guru. And I also know the name of the guru. And this boy was suffering from leukemia. Now, Mohammad Sahab has told us the methods how to get rid of these horrible gurus. You have to write the name of the guru and beat him with shoes. That's the only way you can cure. Now, at that time, nobody would say that you don't criticize. Because the child is 12 years old, suffering from leukemia, will die within 1 month's time. In all compassion, think of it. How dangerous it is, and I should not warn, I'm your mother. I'm not here for any political leadership or any sort of an election. In all compassion, I'm telling you that don't indulge into such things. Now, this fellow, when he got leukemia, and this his father told me, I told him that you beat him with it. He called his father. His father also had to beat that guru. You can ask Dr. Mulevi, there was no trace of leukemia. Within 3 days he cured. But we had to work hard. I'm not here to cure people. Why not I take precautionary measures? Supposing there's something wrong with the penicillin. Won't you say that something wrong with the penicillin? Is it criticism? Why should I criticize? What do I gain by that? I'm not earning any money out of you people. I'm not living on your any support. Why should I not criticize something that is to be criticized? Whatever is to be said has to be said by somebody. Somebody must have that much guts. Say, whatever is right, and whatever is wrong. Come to this left side problem, which I must tell you and warn you, that if you go too much on the left hand side, a kind of very funny situation develops. To such an extent you will be surprised. We have another boy, his name is Ronnie, in London. He's a very well educated boy, everything. And all the time what he does, he's crying. He's doing no work, sleeping in the bed. His name is Ronnie. I said this in Hindi is Roni. He called it Roni Sila. That's what he was. And his mother is fed up of it. Thrice I sent him to his mother. And she said, mother, I cannot bear this boy. He's just doing nothing, crying. I said, what did you do? You won't believe if I tell you what he did, that how these things are. He read Lord Byron by heart. By reading such things, it works on your mind. All these ideas of separation, he's not in separation at all. Nothing wrong with him. But you start identifying. Human beings have a habit to identify. When you start identifying with such things, you do get into troubles. And when you get into troubles, you get direct to the lunatic asylum without even knowing that you are getting mad. Madness. Lunacy, yesterday only there was a boy here who said, mother, I have become mad now. They are going to put me in the lunatic asylum. Among you he was sitting. And he came and told me. Now, if I discover what sort of a thing he has, should I not tell you that this is the reason why people become mad and you just don't do it? We must understand that we always overdo things. Ati sadavarje. That's why it is written that it should be given up. We should keep to our maryadas. Don't go too much emotional also, nor too much intellectual, nor too much physical, but keep a middle part of everything. I'm telling you this because this is one extreme I'm describing to which we go. We Indians are specially gifted by emotional beauty. That's no doubt. But sometimes the way we are attached to things can take us to very wrong things. Like, we may be attached to our family. It's a very good thing. You must do for your family. You must do for your children. In Sahaj Yoga, there is no place for any sannyasa. There is no place at all for any sannyasa. But that does not mean that you sell your country in the name of love. There are people you know who can sell their country. Now, this is a country where persons like Sri Rama have been able to send the wife, the one who was the power behind him in the jungle, just to have a proper public opinion. While we have people in this country, you know that for definite. So many of them are there that just to look after their children, they do not mind doing anything wrong to their own countrymen. Is a very common disease with us, and we must know that we should not overdo it. If we do it, if we overdo it, the relapse comes to us in the form of so many diseases physically and mentally. We get disease. Such people can become mentally absolutely obsessed. They might become blind. They might become very, what you call, dislocated people. Their old age would be very difficult. They may develop gangrene. They may develop even terrible heart troubles, heart attacks. All these things can follow, because if you are overdoing such a thing, it can work out. But surprisingly, it is a very great surprise that when you indulge too much into your emotions, we feel the person is getting a heart attack, because of such a person will cry and weep and say all those things. But actually, if you show to the doctor, he'll say there's no heart attack. Actually, what happens that when you indulge too much into the left hand side, your brain goes out. See how the nature has balanced it. In any lunatic asylum, you go and find out, there won't be one heart attack case. They will look like that. But actually, if you see, you will not find even one person dying of heart attack, because the brain is affected. We are working with our heart and the brain goes out. See the balance the nature has got. So going to the extremes are controlled by the brain. On the left hand side, one has to be careful as to how far to go.
What is meant by going left side?
No, that is what I am trying to say, is to be very emotional. Very emotional. You see, here say, ghazalbaz log are, there are many here, I know that. They are very fond of ghazals. Now these ghazals are, some of them are sung in the name of God, in Milan, in meeting with God, in meeting, whatever is sung is beautiful. But all the time singing of separation is the beginning of the end. Then you start feeling you are so miserable. You will have thousands of things around, but still you will be miserable. You think, oh, what a miserable life I am. I am good for nothing. I have done this thing wrong. You will be torturing your wife and sulking about it. You won't talk to her. She'll say that, why are you not talking to me? You'll say, I'm so moody. This is the beginning. It starts like that. Then you start reading things, how people have been tortured, what has happened to them. Then with that you start also going, you see, the attention starts moving on the left hand side. Then you start attention on the dead. I met the other day a very young girl, very young, you won't believe, hardly 21, just engaged. Very good girl. She, her left side was all finished. I said, what books are you reading? Because I could not think of anything else in her case. And she gave me this Third Eye Fellow, and then what is that another one? I don't know, so many names she gave. They are discussing all about the dead and the devil. Why do you want, I asked her, to read about a devil? Are you going to become a devil? I mean, the thing is, the knowledge which you are not going to use, why do you want to get into? So indulging all these things take you to that. Then further, you can go to some guru who is an expert on Preta Vidya, Smashana Vidya, Bhuta Vidya. The subject is so stunning, you can't imagine how they mesmerize me. They mesmerize you and create confidence in you. You'll be amazed that in Sahaja Yoga, now those we have been working for so many years. Of course, I'm a little shy of publicity, because I sometimes think if you publicize too much, we'll get all kinds of wrong people. But still, whatever publicity we have been making, we have not been able to attract so many people as these fake gurus have been. Though they take lots of money, people pay them money, do all kinds of things. Despite that, people have been going to them. The reason is they have mesmerizing power. They just mesmerize you. Now how the mesmerism starts? See, even from when we are very religious people, mesmerism can start. Like you go to the temple. The gentleman who is sitting there will sell you some sort of a thread. You will be amazed that thread itself may mesmerize. Then you'll go to the same temple. Every time you must go. If you do not go, you feel very funny. All that, you'll give money, money, money to this man. Till you'll discover that something has gone wrong with you. your memory has gone off. You can't think. Something is going wrong in your brain. The brain starts degenerating when you get into these things. Too much of outburst of your emotions should be controlled. And you should keep in the center. But that does not mean that you should be unemotional. We are at one extreme in India, that's why I'm stressing it too much, that we are too much attached to things, which we should not be, to our family, everyone. We should not be attached to that extent that we do not even care for our self-realization. I've seen people who come with their children here and they say, Mother, first cure our child. But what's the use? See, I cure the child. What about you getting the realization, which is the important thing? For them, the most I can do for them is to cure their children, that they don't care even for their self-realization. Now this left side problem, as I was telling you, is accentuated in a very subtle way, like as if they are gods. For example, I don't know in Delhi, but in Bombay there are many women who get devi into them, like they are maid servants, or somebody who washes the clothes or something like that, she gets the devi in her. Then she goes on hum, like that, and people fall at her feet. Now this is nothing but a possession. It's a possession. It's a regular possession. Devi, how can you bear the devi like that when you do not know even how to bear your life? Devi doesn't enter into such wretched women who are good for nothing. They have no holiness in them. How can devi enter into them? But people think that if the devi has come in them, it's very great, and they fall at her feet. The IG, DIG in Bombay has told me that in the villages, this left side working is getting stronger and stronger. And there are many people who are killed like that. There was regular cases going on. There were lots of them, but one of them was brought to my notice. And then with Sahaj Yoga, we could find out the culprit. These forces work out on people who have weak minds, in the sense that who are very sort of very emotional. On the left hand side, also right hand side there are problems, but left hand side absent. So one should not be hard, like a hard boiled egg, but one should not be in such a way that you can be influenced by these negative forces of the left hand side. Now we can see in the West, in the beginning, they were very hard headed people, had no attachment. Even today, you won't believe that in England, every day, two children are killed by their parents. Can you believe it? Regular children, there's nothing wrong with them, are killed by parents every day, two children in England. This is the statistics of England. So you can imagine what must be of America. So they think they are detached. They don't mind even killing their parents or killing their children. This is going to the other extreme of the thing is, and that is the right hand side, which I'll tell you later. So first of all, understand that emotions are to be guided by your wisdom. Any emotion that has no wisdom is useless. Actually, emotions are nothing but expression of your love. And if the love is not collective, it has no meaning. For example, love is like a sap which rises in the tree. It goes to the flower, it goes to the leaves, it goes everywhere. And when it reaches a point where it is just stagnated, say example, in one flower, the whole tree will die and the whole flower will die. In the same way, when we get ourselves completely involved into our family, into our only children, and think of nobody else, we do the same thing to our love. We get stagnated, our children may exploit it, and may become very bad children. They may take it for granted. They may become so horrid that they might be criminals. They can be very spoiled children, good for nothing. And they may not be able to do anything in life. We have seen many children of very fond parents are spoiled like that. And they are sometimes, all their lives are dependent and are parasites. Left-handed people are mostly parasitic by nature. They are very parasitic. We start the parasitic by, say, we ask somebody to look after. Especially in India, I think is a very common thing. We depend on someone. We have to depend on our parents for love, affection, and also for support and money. And the parents go out of their way to help the children because their parents have done that. We have to do. But that doesn't mean we should exploit them. Exploitation of such things can cause left-hand problem. Because gradually what will happen? That your own right-hand side will be absolutely underdeveloped, which is the willpower, will be absolutely underdeveloped, and you'll be good for nothing. So we have to understand that left-handed side has one beginning, ends up into many things. And the worst of all is what we call epilepsy part, or you can say the lunacy part, or when we say a person has gone gaga. These things can come in, so be careful about it and don't go into too many indulgences also. But especially with gurus, you may not like, but I have to tell that most of these gurus who are selling religion, who are selling their methods, are attacking most of them left hand side. There are some who are attacking also right hand side. What they do is to give you a mantra. For example, somebody gives you a mantra of, say, Shiva. Now, one does not know whether the mantra is to be said or not, where it is to be said, why Shiva's mantra is to be given, in one what chakra it is there, for what it is to be used. They just give you call the name of Shiva. Now, Shiva is the highest state, you know that. And you cannot take the name of God just like that. Supposing you have to go and see somebody here, somebody, an ordinary person, even if you have to see somebody like a minister or someone, which is nothing compared to God, or even a prime minister is nothing compared to God, you have to take help from so many people, there's a protocol, you have to take permission, then you go there. But for God, everybody is there. Just calling Shiva, Shiva, Shiva. Is he your servant? The way you order him about, you look after my job, you look after this, you do this. Every time you will take his name and say, do this and do that. This way when you start working, your left side starts raining off. Now this is so common to give a name. Even people come and ask me, mother, give us a name. What name? You see, the Kundalini rises according to its own condition. Supposing your Kundalini has stopped at the Nabhi chakra, then we have to take the name at the Nabhi chakra, isn't it? But supposing the Kundalini is stopping at Nabhi chakra and you are taking the name at Agya chakra, what's the use? Because your Agya chakra has nothing to do. Moreover, the person who is raising the Kundalini has to be authorized. He should be able to raise the Kundalini with enlightened mantra. The mantra is not enlightened. Any Dick, Tom and Harry is taking God's name. You have to enlighten your mantra. And how do you enlighten it? By becoming yourself, by becoming your Atma. When the Atma's light falls in you, or you emit Atma's light, when these vibrations start flowing through you, when you get your Atma Sakshatkar, then alone you can raise the Kundalini. Because then alone your mantras are enlightened. Anybody who thinks that his mantras are alright, is taking this mantra and that mantra, he should know that he is spoiling that particular chakra. Supposing you are taking Shiva's mantra, you will be amazed, you will be catching at the heart where he is. If you are taking Krishna's mantra, you will be amazed, you will be spoiling your Krishna's face. It is such a dangerous thing to do. For example, I would say, now this is an instrument I don't know how to handle. Now I tell you, I do not know whether I to speak from here or from there. I don't know even if it is for speaking or not. Supposing I use this for hammering, what will happen to this? I have to know everything, isn't it? I have to know the whole science. I have to know where the Kundalini is, how it is rising. The difference between other yogis and Sahaja yogis is this, that Sahaja yogis know how to handle the situation. They know how to raise the Kundalini. They know how to put it up, and they know what is the problem of other sins. This is the only difference between ordinary yogis and Sahaja yogis. Because the yogis that are in this world actually are very few. Those are of very great heights also do not want to come on this earth. They say, let us remain somewhere hidden. We do not want to talk to people because they will not understand us, they will crucify us. I have known many of them like that. They just don't want to come to us. The real people are not willing to come down because they have to tell the truth, and you are not going to listen to truth. You have crucified people, those who told you the truth. You like people who will pamper your ego, oh, you are a very nice man. But a person who says the truth, nobody has liked so far. How have you treated other people? You know that. I need not tell you. But you dare not treat me that way because I know how to handle the situation. It's a very different situation today. Even Christ could have finished the whole world. Could have finished the whole world. But why he did not? Because that drama was to be played. He just played the drama. Nobody can touch a person who is above everything. But you try to do that, you will be harmed. And you will know that the harming will come to you in a way that your Kundalini won't rise. Nothing is going to happen to Kundalini. So, with this thing, we should come to the point that the left side persons are mostly people who live in artificialities. In the sense that they live with artificial thoughts. They will be thinking in their head about the Aga Khan's palace. Living in a hut, they'll be thinking about Aga Khan's palace. That, I'm sitting in Aga Khan's palace, this happened, that happened, sort of thing. Not of the future, that I have to live, but just I'm living there, it's a very nice place, I'm just there, sort of thing. This is what is the problem with us, that we do not want to face reality. To face reality, one has to know that it is the most beautiful. It is the thing that we are seeking in life. Once you have the reality, you will be so amazed at yourself. That all this beauty and all this wealth is within me, and oh Lord, I was there, is the source of complete joy which you have to achieve, which you have to receive. That's all within you. You don't have to run here and run. You don't have to do anything of this kind, which is like, as I told you, going to the collective subconscious. Now, in this one, you know that in our country we have many people who try tantricas and who go to other people like that. These are all, as I have told you, are all nothing but Smashana Vidya, Preta Vidya, or Bhuta Vidya. But in that also, what do we see is that, what about my father, what about my mother, what about my job, and all. Now these people, they may tell you something. Because these people have empowered some of the spirits. I'm giving you all the details so that you should know all about it. They have empowered some spirits. They have some spirits in their hands by which they know many things. For example, they will also tell you what was your father's name. Maybe they might also tell you why you have come there, with whom you have come, your name. They will do lots of things like that. But don't run after those things. It is not important. Why should God tell you what was your father's name or what was your name? It's a simple thing. I mean, God is not going to tell you these things. What God is going to give you is the Parama, is the Eternal. He is not going to tell you all these things. Then also they can even tell you the name of the horse which is going to come in the races. They might tell you what is the number or other things that you do, I don't know, some sort of what you call matkas and all that. All this nonsense is God going to do for you? What are you going to reduce God into this nonsense? But many people, you know, indulge. That's the sign of superficiality. They have no depth. They have no depth and they indulge into such horrible things and go and ask people such questions that what is going to happen. You know, to me also they are. They have asked me horse's number, they have asked me all sorts of things. It's most amazing, you know. And to such an extent that countries like America and Russia are indulging it. You'll be amazed they are indulging. If I tell them, they won't listen, but it's a fact. They are all indulging into you under the name of ESP. Once they came to me, and actually three of them, they are scientists or something, I don't remember their name. But there was one Patanjali Shastri, Patanjali, who was the editor. It's one of the magazines and also he worked in Times of India, I don't know. He is a Vatahari. He brought them. But he didn't come himself because he knew I wouldn't like it. And they came to me and they said, Mother, we want to fly in the air. We want to leave our body and become astral. I said, why? You are all going to the moon. Now what to do it? So, no, Mother, we must do. We must have this astral body. We want to go to the astral body. Some or other help us get this astral body thing. I said, what do you want? It is a work of a dead spirit. A dead spirit will come into you and give you this astral body formation. Now, do you want some dead body to overpower you? Do you want that? You will be losing your freedom, which you think is the highest thing, and you will be losing that freedom. Yes, still we will have it. I said, why? He said, because Russians are doing it. I said, really? I didn't know that Russians are doing it. They said, no, we must outwit them. I said, if they are doing wrong, don't go into it. I told them very frankly. But I don't know. They don't want to listen to me. This is it. We must know that when the body... You see, many people have this experience of leaving the body. That is the experience of a spirit coming. That's not a very good experience. But what amazed me the most in this incident was, this Patanjali himself was to do this. To leave his body, his wife was very much worried and this and that. And she came to me and she said, Mother, somehow or other save this husband of mine. I'm worried about him. This is happening. Because she knew it was wrong. And it took 3 months to cure that man. That fellow should send these people to get bhoots into them. And when they give you initiation, they initiate a bhoot into them. We'll leave. All these absurd things are done by such developed countries like and Russia and all, and it's going to happen to them. They will be in the gulf of satans. They will be empowered by satanic forces. How am I to tell them that don't indulge into all these things? And we are the great generators of these horrible tantras. We are exporting them. We are sending them abroad. And here also I find everywhere in every corner such tantric adversity. Now we have here some people who came to me after they had these experiences of tantricas. Their families are ruined, they are absolutely finished, they are good for nothing, and they have lost their jobs, everything is finished, and Tantrika is still flowering. Because for them, those who come, they will exploit, again they will have another person. That's why I want to warn you not to indulge into such things which are wrong, which are left-sided. Now the worst thing that we do very easily is to get into left-hand side is to drink. Now, I don't say you don't drink, just now, because half of you may need. But you get your realization, and then you cannot drink, even if you want. Drinking, drugging, all those things take you to the left. What happened in England? Why people started drinking? It is not because of cold so much, I would say. But why today? If you go in England, you will be surprised, half of the people are drunk in the pubs. Why it has happened there is this, because they had ego-oriented life, right-handed. Too much ego, they developed such a lot of ego that they wanted to run away from there. So they didn't know what to do, so their children ran away from the houses, they took drugs. So that they run away from reality, that is ego for them, they see the ego, the horrid they are, the way they are oppressing others, so they want to get out of it, and that's why they are taking drugs. Now, in India, our young people, you see, they want to be westernized, sophisticated. Not understanding why they are drinking, they are just drinking because they are just taking drugs because others are drinking. Because they are hippies, they think we should be hippies so that we'll be very sophisticated. This is a wrong idea. They are doing it out of search, with intensity. They are really searching people, very deeply searching. And they give up drinks and drugs just like that. I have thousands of people in England itself who have given up everything just like that, overnight. Overnight they have given up everything. But Indians are, though their realization very fast, and they are very good at realization, they lose it also very fast. The reason is because you do not know your life well. I've been telling since yesterday that you are Indians, you are great souls to be born. Gregor himself says so, that you are the people who are highest in spirituality. But what's the use of telling you when you don't want to believe me? It is like sometimes a girl is told that you are the king. So he can't believe it. Even if you put him on the throne, he'll be getting up every time. He won't believe because he is too many. Even if you glue him down there, if anybody is passing by, say, give me 5 rupees. This is the way we are. We are great, no doubt. There's nothing that be confused about. You are great people, but we are so habituated, we have been so much put down because of 300 years of our slavery. Then, you see, we thought we have lost faith in ourselves. We think we are poor people. I mean, what is poverty after all? What is their affluence? It's nothing but plastic. Now, after oil, this thing, you will know who is poor and who is rich. Are they? And how they are going to exist? See, morning till evening. what are they going to do? You see, even they cannot calculate 2 plus 2. For that also they have to use a calculator. How are they going to exist? Their brains are out. Their bodies are out. They can't walk for 10 minutes. They get exhausted. Thank God that we are not that rich. Thank God. That kind of affluence has ruined them completely. Of course, I don't say that we should be beggars. But think that God has saved us from many problems because we have got limited resources. We have lived with maryadas. If we did not have maryadas, we would have been drinking. We would have been drinking like them, drugging, smoking, spoiling our children. The children would have been running away. Wives would be running away. Husbands would be running away. There would have been no society. Thank God that this limited amount that we get has delimited us. And we have not crossed those things that they have crossed, those barriers. They are so foolish and so stupid and so idiotic. You may call me that I'm criticizing them, but if you go and see for yourself, nothing but laughing, that's the way you can live. There are funny, funny things which I don't know how to tell because they're small younger people also. But when you go there, you'll be amazed how the people are there. We are much more wise. But in one thing, we are lacking behind. That is, the young people are really sick. They are not fashionable about it. We are fashionable about seeking. That's also. I would say, especially in England, I think the young people of England are really wonderful things. They are the best young people you could think of. I mean, in the, if you see the quantity of them, is much more. Of course, we have very good seekers in other ways. Also, the quantity of very deep seekers are English people. And young people, they are very different from the English people we know, just the opposite of that. And this is something, such a remarkable thing, that tomorrow they might come here to teach you who is Ganesha, what is Adishakti. This is where we are today. We have no depth of any kind left in us because all of us are destroyed. We have no significance in life. We think we are useless. We are so confused about it. So again, I would request you to see to it that you do not unnecessarily put yourself down and think that you are a part of this or this thing. You are very much part of this. Some of you do not get realization. First, there are something wrong with your chakras, wrong somewhere, which I'm telling you tomorrow. Very clearly, I will be talking. Any gentleman who doesn't want to face the truth need not come. But you can stop me for talking. That's one thing for definite. Those who want to face the truth without feeling bad about it, come down here. I would also request you, if possible, we have a book very well written by the Lord, which is what I've told them, just deep charges we have put on hand. That is, it's a very big book. It costs you about 50 rupees or something like that. Just the printing, because I said no profit is to be made. I'm very particular on that point. Extremely particular. That's how it's just the printing charges that you should take after this program or before this program and go through it and see for yourself how the seeking works out. Now we have here today this program, and tomorrow again I'm going to speak to you about other two channels. But you know that these things take time. First of all, tomorrow I'll be speaking about Ganesha Chakra. And I'll speak about the right-hand side channel, which can be. With this channel, you develop the balloon of psyche, which is called as mana. So when we say that mere man ne ye kaha, you should know that it may be somebody else coming in. So in our country, you see, there's a regular thing. We want to guard ourselves against the mana's dictation. We do not allow ourselves to drift into that mana state. But if you start drifting into mana, now he is bringing tea, what there to see? This is what I, we are so frivolous. If somebody is bringing the tea, a little child coming in, we must see. Everything we must record. Are we here sitting as Sarva Loketeshwara, that sitting, everything must be washed, anything. You see on the way when people go, I've seen in India especially, all the advertisements must be there. If one is missing, they'll stop the car and read. What's the use of all this? I mean, they are being collected. So I'm saying it's a very serious. It's a very serious thing and is evaluated. I'm speaking before you because diamonds, which are chiseled, I know you are. But if your attention is in the dust, what am I to do? Your attention has it. That's all. Then I'll manage it. I'll manage it. You will be surprised that how much powers are there behind you, and all that is, I am going to tell you each and everything, gupta tara gupta kam, everything that is not so far revealed to you in the limit. Only thing is, keep yourself in the center. Today please go and buy some photographs. I don't know if they are selling the photographs, they are simple things, just buy them and then meditate this evening. Again tomorrow you come and we are going to again have a meditation thing. The more you expose to it, the better it will be. Go deeper into it, deeper into it. And then you will know what all these great saints and prophets have said, all the scriptures that have described, that to know yourself is the aim of it. May God bless.
But we have seen you, we are seeing you face to face. But you said we purchase your photo, so in what respect your photo is going to help us?
Now, photo is a very authentic thing. You see, so far all the murtis and everything are not so authentic. Because there is vibration passing through me, I discover to my great amazement and joy that my photo has the same vibration. So if you use the photograph, you can work it out. If you don't want to use the photograph, it doesn't work out in the beginning. To begin with, there is an alambhan of my photograph. But what is, why should you have objection to my photograph if you can have me there? Why can't you have my photograph? Supposing you have anybody's photograph. See, you will have even Indira Gandhi's photograph, you will have everybody's photograph. Why not mine? What's such an objectionable thing about it? I don't understand. It emits good vibrations. You see, this is the trouble. You will have everybody's photograph. All kinds of nonsensical people you will have.
We have got your vibration right now.
Right now, but when you will work on the photograph, it will be deeper. See, because photograph will remain with you, you just try what I'm telling you. You just try what I'm telling you. You see, by that I'm not going to gain anything again. You see, you are used to a shopping spirit. You always do something as if you are shopping. Here you are not shopping. You are taking. I'm giving. You are not giving me anything you cannot give. I'm at a point where you cannot give me. So you take it. And how to take it is very embarrassing. But I have to tell you how to take it. I'll have to also tell it how to sit before me. What to do? You are so such small children, you don't know. Maybe by certain things you may spoil your vibrations. You must know how to respect your mother. If you do not know, all of them are within me. These, all these great saints are sitting there with him. They will not like it, you see. So I have to tell you even that. Today only I was telling, it's very embarrassing life that I have to tell everything to them. Somebody I went to, they wanted to give me water, you see, they gave me in a plastic glass. I said, it's all right. If they give me in plastic glass, but it's not all right otherwise. You must understand. This is not the way to give water to your mother, who is a divine person. You need not, I'm not saying anything, but with respect. You just get some dirty glass and give it to mother, it's not the way it is to be done. You see, you must understand, after all, you come from a country which has samskaras, which knows what is a puja, what is a holy person is, and everything is. And then when you know that, you should understand that this is very important for that, whatever is needed to be done. If you have a photograph of a wrong person, your house will be ruined. Even diamond, you have seen it happens. If you have the photograph of a holy person, everything will be alright. It is for your good, I'm not going to gain anything out of it. And photograph is not that expensive that you should think about. First we start just now. It's the minimum price, I think 1 rupee. If you can afford it, I'll be happy. Thank you.